Hello friends, welcome to ProTalent, and this is our second session on Indian Constitution. Being a part of legal reasoning, I'm sure Constitution turns out to be a very critical section for many of you. And primarily, in our first session, we discussed about how Constitution was made, and we also understood details about the preamble. Now, in this session, we are going to discuss three critical factors. Number one, we are going to discuss part one. Number two, we are going to discuss part two, which is about citizenship of India. And we are going to discuss about part number three, which is fundamental rights. Okay. Now, this entire module is designed from a perspective of CLAT examination. So, the kind of questions which are basically coming from legal GK as well as you can say legal reasoning, both are covered in this particular session. Okay. So after this session, we are going to cover one more module on Indian Constitution, wherein we are going to pick up some important points. We are not going to cover the entire Constitution because that will be unnecessary for a CLAT examination, but something which is in-depth study which is needed will be here, and that is what discussed in our original discussion wherein we talked about plan of action. Okay. Now, the entire, you can say, PDF will be available to you at protalentdigital.com. In addition to that, those students who are interested to purchase our study material, please, we have made a separate video for that. Go through that, register there, and we will send material to you. So a lot of students have got benefited out of that. So we thank you very much for giving us such a superb response for this. Okay. So let me start about this session number two for Indian Constitution. Let me start with this preamble. We talked about preamble, and what is very important is who made this preamble. It is a people. We, the people of India, we made it, and we have given it to ourselves. And on what particular date we have given to ourselves? It was on 26th November 1949. The head of Constituent Assembly was Dr. Rajendra Prasad, and within that there were various drafting committees. Uni puri Constituent Assembly ke andar bahut sari committees hoti thi, unme se ek committee thi jo draft karne ki, that is jo pura ka pura argument likhne ki jo committee thi, that is called drafting committee, aur uske jo chairman the, that was Dr. B. R. Ambedkar. Okay. And he envisaged this India to be sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic and republic. I'm sure you remember that. Okay. Sovereign, samprabhuta. We are the god on our own. Nobody is above us. We are not influenced by anyone. Socialist, welfare state. Sarkar, logo ke bhale ke liye banai gayi hai. Secular, sarvadharma sambhav. Sabhi dharma same hai. Democratic and republic. Democratic is the people ruling. Republic is a representative of the people. And to secure to all citizens the justice, liberty and equality. These three words we adopted from French Revolution. French Revolution mein ye teen word banaye gaye the, justice, liberty, equality. So we adopted that we would like to give such kind of thing to our own people, that is justice, liberty and equality. Okay. And we also expect them to have a fraternity among themselves and ensuring unity and integrity of the nation. This is what the preamble is. And aap sabko pata hoga, ye jo ye italics karke rakha hua hai, theek hai, ye teen word, theek hai, this one, two and this three. These three words were introduced in 42nd amendment of our constitution. I hope that is very clear to you. Theek hai, chale, great. So that was about preamble. Now, we talked about that our constitution is divided into various parts, and in that we have the first part we are talking about, that is called the Union and its territory. Okay. Part 1, article number 124. Part 1 is about article number 124 that talks about laws pertaining to the Constitution of India as a country and the Union of States and that it is made up. So we are not United States of India. We are Union of India. So we are one. We are union. So that means we are one. Together we are one. Again, where we have divided different states, and this different states may have their own way of working, but together they are part of, you can say, India. Unlike USA, jahan pe it's a United States of India, wahan ka subsystem alag hai. People have a dual citizenship, state ka alag, center ka alag lena padta hai unko. There's a federal system, fully federal system, while in India we have a semi-federal system. Theek hai? Okay, so here we are talking about that what is the name of our country. It says India or Bharat, and it will be named as Union of India. Together it is called one. We are not divided. Aisa nahi tha ki alag alag bhag tha, hum ikatta hoke one bane. Aisa nahi hai. We are one from day one. This is what the idea is. Okay? Theek hai. And part one tabhi aata hai jab hame koi nayi territory hamare andar leni ho, ya hamare mein se koi territory bahar karni ho, ya koi naya state form karna ho, ya from within a state do state alag karne ho, unka naam badalna ho. All those purpose we have this part one to be revoked. Okay, so that is what to be invoked. Article number two says admission or establishment of new states. Okay, parliament may by law admit into the union or establish new states on such terms and condition as it thinks fit. So Sikkim 1975 mein jab Bharat mein juda, so it was through article number two, while article number three ke dwara Andhra Pradesh mein se Telangana bana. Andhra Pradesh mein se Telangana bana. Formation of new states or alteration of areas, boundaries or names of existing states, ye sab aayega article number 3 mein. So article number 1 2 4 are important because they define who are we, what is the boundary we have. Theek hai, that is what it defines. And after defining boundary, ye boundary banane ke baad, now we have to define ki is boundary mein kis basis ke upar hum yahan ke logo ko citizenship award karenge. Who will be part of this boundary, as in the people who will be part of this boundary, will be defined in the next part, which is called part 2. Part 2 is article number 5 to 11, article number 5 to 11, which is connected with the citizenship of India. Okay, so we have Indian citizenship. It can be acquired in following 5 ways. Again, Indian citizenship can be acquired in following 5 ways. Remember, India gives unique, that is single citizenship. Okay, if someone acquires some other country's citizenship, automatically that person is debarred from Indian citizenship. Okay, chaliye, great. 5 tarike kaun kaun se. Pehla, citizenship at the commencement of the constitution. So jab India ka constitution commence hua, okay, tab agar yahan pe jo log the, jo bhi territory mein log the, that is what we said, ke they will be part of India. Citizenship by birth, if any person is born in India, agar koi banda India mein born hua hai, to at the time of his birth, let's say one of his parents is Indian, then the person will get the citizenship of this country. That is called citizenship by birth. Then we have a citizenship by descent. Koi bhi Indian parent se koi bhi bachcha paida hua, kahin pe bhi paida hua, that person can acquire Indian citizenship. This is by descent. Citizenship by registration. Someone would like to apply here. Again, that is basically someone is interested ki bhai, I want to stay here. For example, there was a Pakistani singer called Adnan Sami. He became part of India through registration. And then we have a citizenship by naturalization. Citizenship by naturalization. Somewhere someone is, let's say, married to an Indian, or fir usko India mein rehna hai, or India ki jo country hai uske kuch benefits lene hai, so that person applies for citizenship for naturalization. This is how the acquisition of citizenship can be done. Remember, in India we largely follow jus sanguini, which means citizenship of right of blood. Khoon ke dwara agar koi banda hai, hum usko Indian mante hai, as opposed to just soil, which is citizenship by right of birth within the territory. In USA, it is generally just soli, which means agar koi bhi bachcha उसके पेरेंट्स कहीं के भी हो, इफ इज बॉर्न इन अमेरिका ही गेट्स सिटीजनशिप ऑफ अमेरिका, वाइल इन इंडिया वी वुड लाइक टू चेक whether that person is, though the person is born in India, whether his blood is Indian or not. That is what we try to focus on. So we follow jus sanguini, while America follows jus soli. Okay, few more information about this is Indian nationality largely follows jus sanguini as opposed to jus soli. Abhi humne baat kari. The president of India is termed as a first citizen of our country. This is very important. Okay, now kaun kaun se law hai इसके मुताबिक, there is a citizenship act 1955 which has been amended by citizenship amendment act 1986 and later on it was amended in 2003, later on it was amended in 2005 and then it was recently amended in 2014. Okay, so this is how the various amendment took place. Okay, चलिए आगे बढ़ते हैं. इसके साथ साथ आपको दो तीन और words पता होने चाहिए. पहला word आपके सामने यहाँ लिखा हुआ है which is called PIO. What is PIO? PIO means person of Indian origin, which is a card given. Other is called OCI, overseas citizen of India. Okay, these are the card given. Remember, we follow jus sanguini, that is citizenship by right of blood, which means what we are interested in is someone who is born outside India, but the parents were Indian, and even though person has not taken Indian citizenship, we would like to pass on certain benefits of India to that person. And for that, we provide them PIO, person of Indian origin, or overseas citizen of India. Remember, these two words are connected with something connected to citizenship, but they are not citizenship. Remember that. Okay. Okay. While another term called NRI, NRI has no connection with citizenship. NRI has only one connection, which is income tax. Okay, NRI word comes from income tax only, which is called non-resident Indian. Someone, anyone, whether Indian or non-Indian, who has stayed for less than 180 days in India in a given assessment year. कोई एक particular assessment year मतलब जिस समय पे आपका financial transaction गिना जा रहा है, उस financial transaction year के अंदर, अगर उस बंदे ने 180 दिन से कम दिन अगर इंडिया में रहता है, तो then that person will automatically will become NRI और उसका income tax का जो calculation है वो तो अलग तरीके से होगा compared to resident Indian. So there is no connection with citizenship there. Even if you are a citizen of India and you are largely staying outside India, so you are staying for throughout 1 year in let's say Dubai, that means you are NRI symbol for that year. Okay, that is for the income tax purpose. Having no connection with the nationality, nationality will still remain Indian. Okay, chaliye aage badhte hain. Moving towards, this is our part 2. Now we go and talk about part 3. Part 3 talks about fundamental rights. This is one of the very important discussion in our, you can say, today's talk. This is fundamental rights, very important. Okay, now these are the rights. Adhikar ki baat ho rahi hai, rights. You know, rights can come from many sources. Rights alag alag tarike se aa sakte hain. For example, let us say you got admission into let's say NLU Bangalore, and you decided to stay possibly outside NLU Bangalore, and you acquired a small house. You rented it, you have given rent to a landlord, and you took a house and you are staying there. Okay, so by paying money to that landlord, you acquired certain rights, and of utilizing that house. Kya kya aapne aapko adhikar mile hai? You can stay, you can come at any point in time, you can go at any point in time, in whatever manner you want to use that room, you can use it. Room ke andar aap gadde kahin pe bhi rakho, padhai ka saman kahin pe bhi rakho, nobody will stop. Theek hai, possibly us room ke andar agar aapko koi kill thok nahi ho, koi construction ka kaam karna ho, you don't have that right. You have to ask permission from the landlord. Okay, so that is how the rights you have acquired, but that's a limited right. Okay, even landlord has a limited right. In case, let's say you want to start a pizza factory in that small room, you want to start a pizza factory, possibly you need to take permission of landlord. Landlord gives you permission, but even after taking landlord's permission, still you need to take permission from municipality. म्युनिसिपालिटी ऑफ बैंगलोर इज वॉट यू नीड टू टेक परमिशन फॉर फ्रॉम. सो वो आपको अधिकार देगी कि आप वहां पे ये पिज्जा की फैक्ट्री खोल सकते हैं कि नहीं. ठीक है. एंड फॉर एग्जाम्पल जैसे यू वॉन्ट टू रन सम न्यूक्लियर पावर प्लांट इन साइड दैट पर्टिकुलर रूम. ठीक है. एंड पॉसिबली म्युनिसिपालिटी गिव्स यू अप्रूवल बट सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट सेज स्टॉप इट इज माई टेरिटरी आई कैन नॉट गिव यू दैट परमिशन आई विल नॉट गिव यू राइट. ठीक है. तो इस तरीके से राइट्स अलग अलग जगह से आते हैं. ठीक है. सो दैट्स अ मीनिंग ऑफ राइट अधिकार. ठीक है. अब ये फंडामेंटल राइट्स का मतलब क्या है. फंडामेंटल राइट्स का मतलब है कि हमने जब राइट्स बनाने की कोशिश करी कि हमारे देश के लोगों को हमारे सिटीजन्स को या यहाँ पे कोई रहता है उसको अगर हमें अधिकार देने हैं. ठीक है. तो वो अधिकार किस तरीके के होने चाहिए. कैन वी गिव देम एब्सोल्यूट राइट. कैन वी गिव देम ऑल द काइंड ऑफ राइट्स. देन वी डिसाइडेड कि वी कैन गिव देम एब्सोल्यूट राइट बट दोज राइट्स आर कमिंग फ्रॉम होम. सो देन वी डिसाइडेड कि वी कैन ओनली प्रोटेक्ट सर्टन काइंड ऑफ राइट्स. अदर राइट्स फॉर द प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ अदर राइट्स वी नीड टू डिवाइज सर्टन मैकेनिज्म. ठीक है. तो अगर इफ यू आर गवर्नमेंट इफ यू आर इंडियन गवर्नमेंट वी कैन प्रोटेक्ट ओनली सर्टन काइंड ऑफ राइट्स. ठीक है. एंड दे आर कॉल्ड फंडामेंटल राइट्स. ठीक है. दे आर फंडामेंटल राइट्स. दिस राइट्स आर अवेलेबल टू पीपल इन इंडिया. दिस राइट्स आर अवेलेबल टू पीपल इन इंडिया अगेंस्ट द स्टेट. रिमेंबर भारत में जो फंडामेंटल राइट्स है दे आर अवेलेबल अगेंस्ट द स्टेट. कुछ राइट्स है यू वॉन्ट टू टेक इट अगेंस्ट पीपल. नाउ दोस बिकम्स लीगल राइट्स. आदमियों के अगेंस्ट में चाहिए, सिटीजन्स के अगेंस्ट चाहिए, ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के अगेंस्ट चाहिए, तो वो आपको लीगल राइट्स हो जाएंगे. और उसको प्रोटेक्ट करने के लिए प्रॉपर लीगल सिस्टम और दूसरे लॉ बना के रखे हुए हैं. व्हाइल दिस फंडामेंटल राइट्स आर क्लियरली मेंशन इन अवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन और उस कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में लिखे हुए हैं दैट दे आर गिवन टू इधर सिटीजन्स और सर्टन राइट्स आर गिवन इवन टू नॉन सिटीजन्स एज वेल. हमने ये भी ध्यान रखा है कि जब हमने कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन बनाया ठीक है तो हमने लोगों को अधिकार दिए तो हमने सिर्फ ये नहीं सोचा कि ये अधिकार सिर्फ और सिर्फ भारत के लोगों को मिलेंगे दैट इज सिटीजन ऑफ इंडिया. और हमने सोचा कि अधिकार कुछ जो सिटीजन नहीं है उनको भी मिलने चाहिए और उसके द्वारा हमने ये अधिकारों के बारे में बात करी. ये आइडिया जो फंडामेंटल राइट्स का आइडिया है वी टुक इट फ्रॉम US कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. हमने अमेरिका के कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन से ये फंडामेंटल राइट का आइडिया उठाया है. ठीक है. सो वी गॉट इंस्पायर्ड थ्रू वेरियस सोर्सेस. सो वन ऑफ द सोर्स फॉर अवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन वॉज US सिटीजन. ओके. सो आई होप दैट इज वेरी क्लियर. सो रिमेंबर देर आर मेनी प्लेसेस फ्रॉम वेर यू हैव यू कैन से इंस्पिरेशन कमिंग अप एंड यू ऑल्सो गेट लॉट ऑफ सोर्सेस. ओके. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल ये जो पूरा ये PPT बना के रखा है दैट ऑल्सो कम्स फ्रॉम सोर्सेज लाइक इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, विकीपीडिया एंड लॉट ऑफ अदर ऑनलाइन रिसोर्सेज. ओके. सो आई होप दैट इज वेरी क्लियर इन योर माइंड. चलिए ग्रेट. सो सबसे पहले हमने बात करी कि दिस फंडामेंटल राइट्स आर अवेलेबल अगेंस्ट द स्टेट. किसके खिलाफ मिले हैं? स्टेट के खिलाफ. ओके. सो देयरफॉर इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर अस टू डिफाइन व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ अ स्टेट. ओके. सो इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू डिफाइन व्हाट इज अ स्टेट. अ स्टेट इंक्लूड्स गवर्नमेंट, पार्लियामेंट है ना, एंड गवर्नमेंट एंड लेजिस्लेचर ऑफ ईच ऑफ द स्टेट और ऑल लोकल और अदर अथॉरिटीज विद इन द टेरिटरी ऑफ इंडिया अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. सिंपल. सो स्टेट गवर्नमेंट आ गया, विधानसभा आ गई, सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट आ गई, लोकसभा आ गई, राज्यसभा आ गई, ये सब स्टेट के पार्ट है. बराबर है. या जिन जिन लोगों को सरकार की तरफ से फंडिंग मिली है, जिन जिन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन को, दैट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विल ऑल्सो बिकम अ पार्ट ऑफ. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल लेट्स से म्युनिसिपैलिटी ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर एरिया विल बिकम अ स्टेट. ठीक है. विल बिकम अ स्टेट. व्हाइल CBSE विल बिकम अ स्टेट. ठीक है. नीट will become a state, CLAT will become a state in that sense. So, state includes this following people. State includes executive, legislature, local or other authorities within the territory of India, local and other authorities under the control of executive, as well as judiciary other than judicial function. Okay, judiciary other than judicial function ka kya matlab ho gaya? Judiciary jab judgment deti hai, tab wo state nahi hai. Par judiciary ke andar एक इंपॉर्टेंट काम रहता है. जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल है ना, हमारा केस गया, हमारा केस सुप्रीम कोर्ट में गया और सुप्रीम कोर्ट के जो चीफ जस्टिस ऑफ इंडिया है उनको डिसाइड करना है कि ये केस कौन से जज के पास जाएगा, तो उस पर्पस के लिए, उस पर्पस के लिए सुप्रीम कोर्ट विल बिकम अ स्टेट, और वहां पे अगर उन्होंने हमारे कोई अधिकारों को, हमारे राइट्स को वायलेट किया, हमारे फंडामेंटल राइट को वायलेट किया, देन वी कैन गो टू द कोर्ट, फाइट एंड से हमारे फंडामेंटल राइट्स वायलेट हो रहे हैं, तो प्लीज हमें वो वापस दीजिए. दिस इज वॉट वी कैन डू इन दिस सिनेरियो. ओके, सो आई होप दिस इज वेरी क्लियर दैट आर्टिकल नंबर 12 डिफाइंस स्टेट क्या होता है. ठीक है, और आपको एग्जाम में जो लीगल रीजनिंग के क्वेश्चंस आएंगे उधर भी यू हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल कि ये जो राइट आपको मिला है वो किसके खिलाफ मिला है. इज इट अवेलेबल अगेंस्ट एन इंडिविजुअल और इट इज अ फंडामेंटल राइट, देन इट इज अवेलेबल टू यू अगेंस्ट द स्टेट. रिमेंबर दैट. ओके, तो आपको ये डिफाइन करना पड़ेगा कि वो राइट स्टेट के खिलाफ है या लोगों के खिलाफ है. ओके, चलिए आगे बढ़ते हैं. सो दैट इज अबाउट द आर्टिकल नंबर 12. Then we have article number 13. Article number 13 bolta hai, the laws which are inconsistent with or are in derogation of fundamental rights. Jo bhi laws fundamental rights ke inconsistent hai, ya they are in the derogation of fundamental right, then those laws are not acceptable. Theek hai? Therefore it is called supremacy of fundamental rights. Fundamental rights are supreme, which means कोई भी लॉ विद इन अ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन और आउटसाइड कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इन अवर इंडियन टेरिटरी, इफ दे आर मेड एंड दे वायोलेट अवर फंडामेंटल राइट्स और दे आर इनकंसिस्टेंट विद अवर फंडामेंटल राइट और दे डेरोगेट फंडामेंटल राइट, देन दे विल बी टर्म्ड एज वॉइड. ओके, लेट्स रीड द वर्ड्स. क्या वर्ड्स लिखे? रिमेंबर, लॉ पढ़ना है शांति से, लैंग्वेज पढ़ना बहुत जरूरी है. भले थोड़ा लंबा लंबा लगे, इट विल टेक सम लॉन्ग टाइम to understand this, but that's the only way to remember that. Okay, मैं जो शब्द बोल रहा हूँ, ठीक है, उससे आप समझ पाएंगे, पर आपको ये भी समझना है, जो written words है, उससे भी समझना बहुत जरूरी है. Okay, चलिए देखते हैं. All laws in the force in the territory of India immediately before the commencement of this constitution, in so far as they are inconsistent with the provision of this part, which is part 3, shall to that extent will be inconsistent and it will be void. It will be void. Void means empty. क्या होता है वो? खाली है. Okay? ठीक है. The state, remember number 2 point, state shall not take any law which takes away, the state shall not make any law which takes away or abridges the rights. है ना? या तो उसको कम कर दे या तो उसको निकाल दे. ना, ऐसे कोई लॉ बना नहीं सकता है. सर, ऐसे कोई लॉ बने थे क्या पहले जिसको इन्होंने आर्टिकल नंबर 13 के मुताबिक निकाल दिया हो? यस, सेक्शन 66A ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी एक्ट 2000. ठीक है, ये एक्ट, ठीक है, बहुत ही मजेदार एक्ट था. इसके अंदर ऐसा लिखा गया था दैट इफ यू कम्युनिकेट थ्रू एनी कंप्यूटर, एनी मीडियम विच इज अ डिजिटल मीडियम एंड ड्यू टू विच if there is a possibility that it may affect law and order, sunna hai, bahut mazedar hai. If there is a possibility iski wajah se koi law and order ko impact hota hai, then hai na, you may be put behind the bar. theek hai, aaj se kuch samay pehle Mumbai mein jab Bala Sahib Thackeray ji ki maut hui thi, tab ek ladki thi, usne Facebook pe likha ki ek aadmi ke marne ke upar itna halla kis baat ka, ऐसा करके लिखा था. और एक और फ्रेंड उसकी जो थी, उसने उस कमेंट को लाइक किया था और उसके बेसिस के ऊपर पुलिस ने उनको पकड़ के जेल में डाल दिया. बिकॉज देयर वाज अ पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ इंपैक्टिंग लॉ एंड ऑर्डर, बट दैट इज अगेंस्ट अवर फंडामेंटल राइट ऑफ फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच. ठीक है, अब फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच के मुताबिक उन्होंने कोई गलत काम नहीं किया था, तो उनको वो अधिकार मिलना चाहिए. सुप्रीम कोर्ट में ये केस पहुंचा, सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने देखा दैट सेक्शन 66A ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी एक्ट 2000 इज अनटेनेबल विद अवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. कैसा है वो? अनटेनेबल. इसलिए उसको उन्होंने डिस्कार्ड कर दिया, उसको वॉइड कर दिया इन दिस आर्टिकल, अनलेस एंड अदरवाइज. ठीक है, दिस कॉन्टेक्स्ट रिक्वायर्स द लॉ इंक्लूड्स एनीथिंग लाइक ऑर्डिनेंस, ऑर्डर, बाय लॉ, रूल, रेगुलेशन, नोटिफिकेशन, कस्टम और यूसेज anything which have a tendency to become a law, that is called, you can say, law here. Laws in force includes laws passed or made by the legislature or other competent authority in the territory of India before the commencement of this constitution and not previously repealed, notwithstanding that any such law or any part thereof may not be then in the operation either at all in a particular area. So this says that any law, it may be ordinance, it may be order, it may be bylaw, it may be rule. Okay. So this is what they said, and nothing in this article shall apply to any amendment of this constitution made under article number 368. Okay. So it says ki aap law bana sakte ho, theek hai, par you cannot amend article 368. Kiske bare mein hai? That is about amendment of our Indian constitution. So you want to amend something, you can amend, you can amend our constitution, but it should not impact our basic structure of the constitution. Hamare basic structure ko ye impact karna nahi chahiye. This is what the amendment or related part, article number 13. So article number 12 kya baat kar raha tha? Fundamental right kiske khilaf milte hai? State. So it defines state. Article number 13 kya bolta hai? It is fundamental rights are supreme. So koi bhi law banaya jayega, agar wo fundamental right ko violate karega, to wo law to that extent becomes void. Utna hi part, pura ka pura nahi hata diya jayega, pura information technology act nahi hata diya. It is only that 66A ka section tha, usko hata diya. I hope that is very clear. Okay, chaliye, great. Aage badhte hain, and we talk about article number 14. Uske baad ka hai, bahut mahatvapurna article hai, acche se samajhiyega. So article number 14 talks about equality before law. Theek hai, remember kya likha inhone, humne baat kari thi fundamental rights are given to citizens as well as to other people. Theek hai, jo citizen nahi hai usko bhi wo fundamental right milega. Theek hai, chaliye, great. To kuch kuch law sirf citizens ko milenge, kuch kuch rights sirf citizens ko milenge, kuch dono ko milenge, aur ye article number 14 is given to all. So kya likha hai, state shall not deny to any person equality before law or the equal protection within the territory of India. So it says equality before law means everyone is equal before law. So that means if there is a case tomorrow against Mr. Nitin Parmar and Mr. Narendra Modi, so in the eyes of law, both of them are equal. Both of them are equal. It will not be termed as Mr. Modi is a prime minister of this country and therefore he will be treated in a different way. No, everyone will be same, and there is equal protection of law. That means, okay, like should be treated alike. Okay, equal protection of law. Ek to law banane ke time pe jo banaya jayega usme equality ka dhyan rakha jayega, aur jab implementation ki baat aayegi tab bhi equality ka dhyan rakha jayega. Okay, so equality before law, okay, at the time of creation also equality will be maintained. Okay, so that is very important. However, in this article number 14, there are certain beneficial discrimination, or it will be termed as affirmative action, are provided. Okay, so there are special provision for socially and educationally backward classes, SCs, NSTs. There are reservation for the appointment of backward classes, as well as there are certain benefits are given to women, and there are certain articles specifically for SCs and STs. Okay, so that is called affirmative action. That is called affirmative action. Okay, we are not getting into a discussion of reservation, but we are trying to understand, there is a clear thought which is coming that there are certain group of people who are not fully equipped. Okay, aur unko ek tarike ka support dena chahiye. For example, ek bahut simple sa example hai, CLAT ki taiyari karni hai. CLAT ki taiyari mein jyadatar English medium is a very critical part. Okay, par jo log tribal area mein rehte hain, jinhone English medium mein padhai nahi kari hai, unke yahan pe aaju aaju CLAT ka coaching nahi hai, to wo log kya karenge? Theek hai, to jo tribal log hai, that means they are from scheduled tribe caste, so scheduled tribe people will get certain benefit in terms of their admission. Okay, and this ProTalent is trying to focus on those people as well. Dur dur tak, gaon gaon tak hamari ye baatein pahunche ki hum ye CLAT ka education aapko dene ki koshish kar rahe hain. So please, aap usko spread kariye. Mujhe lagta hai ki aap logo ko jyada se jyada hamari baatein dur phailani chahiye. Share this in your Facebook, on your Twitter and through your WhatsApp, please share these videos and tell to large number of people that they are getting CLAT preparation here on YouTube. Okay, chali, great. So that's article number 14. Article number 14 to 18, they are basically part of equality before law. So there are certain articles which talks about that there cannot be any title. Kisi ke naam ke aage sir nahi lagega. So we have a Sir Vivian Richards, is from West Indies, and we have a Tendulkar. Tendulkar ke aage koi sir nahi lagta hai. Okay. So because we want to make sure that there is equality everywhere, social equality, except in military, in education, wherein we have given that lieutenant commander, major general, okay, while in education we say assistant professor, associate professor, professor, ye sab jo humne naam diye hai, that is the kind of distinction karne ke liye jo diye hai, wahan pe ye exception chalega, but otherwise everyone will be treated equally in the eyes of law. There will not be any Raja. There is no Raja Maharaja. There is no Raja Dhiraj. There is no Chhatrapati. Okay? There is no Shahin Shah. Okay? Aisa koi isin ke naam ke aage nahi lagega. Okay? So, ye bilkul dhyan rakhega. Okay? Chaliye aage badhte hain. And then we have article number 19. Article number 19 is given to the citizens of this country. Okay? This is given to citizens of this country. And it is given all citizens. This is how it starts. Now, this is not given to everyone. If someone is coming tomorrow from, let's say, Argentina, and he wants to speak certain things, and if he, whatever he is trying to speak, will have some impact on our, you can say, country, then possibly we may stop him saying that, ki aap na bole. Okay, that's how it is. Okay. So, freedom. Chhe tarike ki freedom humne isme di hai. Freedom of speech and expression. Hai na? Bhai, kisi ko apni baatein rakhne ka, अपनी अभिव्यक्ति रखने का फ्रीडम है, ठीक है. आर्टिकल नंबर 19(1) ने हमें स्वतंत्रता दी है, ठीक है, किस चीज की, हमें कोई भी अभिव्यक्ति करने की, ठीक है. आर्टिकल नंबर 19(2) बोलता है कि हमें स्वतंत्रता मिली है, किस चीज की स्वतंत्रता मिली है, हमें शांतिपूर्ण बिना हथियार के एकत्रित होने के लिए और सम्मेलन करने की स्वतंत्रता है, ठीक है. फिर हमें जो तीसरी जो स्वतंत्रता मिली है, दैट इज संगठन बनाने की स्वतंत्रता मिली है, ठीक है. फिर हमें मिली है चौथी स्वतंत्रता, दैट इज हमें भारत में कहीं पे भी बसने की स्वतंत्रता मिली है, सिर्फ जम्मू और कश्मीर को छोड़कर, और हमें कहीं पे भी हमारा कोई भी तरीके का ट्रेड या प्रोफेशन हमें करना है, ठीक है, हम कर सकते हैं. सो दिस इज व्हाट द फ्रीडम अवेलेबल टू अस, फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच एंड एक्सप्रेशन, फ्रीडम टू असेंबल पीसेबली विदाउट आर्म्स, फ्रीडम टू फॉर्म एसोसिएशन एंड यूनियन, to move freely throughout the territory of India, to reside and settle in India, and to practice any profession. Okay, remember, this freedoms are not absolute. Kisi ko absolute freedom nahi ho sakti, because aapke paas koi freedom hai, to aapka wo adhikar wahan pe ruk jayega, jahan pe kisi aur ka adhikar chalu hoga. So therefore, this freedom cannot be absolute. Okay, so ye jo freedom hai, they come with reasonable restriction. Okay, they come with a reasonable restriction. Usme koi restrictions honge, theek hai bhai. Agar mano mujhe YouTube ke upar kahin pe bolne ki zarurat hai, abhi pura freedom hai, main sab kuch bol sakta hu YouTube ke upar. Agar main YouTube ke madhyam ke dwara kisi ko agar defame karna chahta hu, theek hai, to wo mujhe usme injection milega, koi mujhe rok diya jayega, kyunki wo meri freedom hai, par main kisi ki freedom ko pareshan nahi kar sakta. So sawal ye aata hai कि सरकार की तरफ से अगर रिस्ट्रिक्शन लगाया गया है, सो इज दैट अ रीजनेबल और नॉट, दैट्स अ बिग क्वेश्चन, ठीक है. सरकार की तरफ से अगर रिस्ट्रिक्शन लगाया गया है, तो ये रीजनेबल रिस्ट्रिक्शन है या नहीं, ये बताना बहुत जरूरी है. और उसके लिए यू हैव टू आस्क दिस थ्री क्वेश्चंस. पहला सवाल आपको बताना है कि भैया, पहला सवाल आपको ये बताना है कि इज द रिस्ट्रिक्शन एब्सोल्यूट और इट इज पार्शियल, मतलब ये रिस्ट्रिक्शन पूरा है या पार्शियल है. पूरी कोई चीज का रिस्ट्रिक्शन एक्सेप्टेबल नहीं होता है, ठीक है. सो देयरफॉर दैट इज वन. नंबर टू, व्हाट इज द पर्पस गवर्नमेंट इज ट्राइंग टू अचीव थ्रू दिस रिस्ट्रिक्शन, इज इट इन द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ पब्लिक और इज इट इन अ नेशनल इंटरेस्ट. इफ इट इज इन नेशनल इंटरेस्ट, इफ इट इज इन नेशनल इंटरेस्ट, देन द रिस्ट्रिक्शन कैन बी टर्म्ड रीजनेबल. एंड वॉज देयर एनी अदर वे of achieving that purpose, or was putting a restriction on the fundamental right, the only way, if it is the only way, then it is called reasonable restriction. Let me give you an example. For example, agar aap ek jagah se dusri jagah aap road pe ek city mein hai, aap ek jagah se dusri jagah jana chahte hain aur wahan pe jo local government hai usne kuch area cordon kar diya hai kyunki unko shayad organ transplantation ke liye hai na kisi ki kidney ya kisi ka liver ya kisi ka heart hai na ek cold box mein rakh kar ek jagah se dusri jagah bahut tezi se pahunchana hai theek hai uske liye unhone kuch area ko green corridor cordon karke rakha hai wahan pe koi ja nahi sakta hai aisa karke unhone rakh diya hai theek hai if for that purpose they restrict your movement and they restrict your movement to go to a particular direction, that's okay, that is called reasonable restriction. Okay, that is called reasonable restriction. theek hai ab kya kya cheeze reasonable restriction nahi ho sakti hai. ab jaise kuch samay pehle India mein Padmavat naam ki movie ko release karna tha and there are people who objected it that this is going against their religion or their, you can say, ideology or their history. okay, तो उस समय पे वो फ्रीडम जिस जो डायरेक्टर उस मूवी को रिलीज करना चाहता था उसकी फ्रीडम को वो अफेक्ट कर रहा था तो ही डिमांडेड दैट हिज फ्रीडम टू बी प्रोटेक्टेड एंड हिज फ्रीडम वाज प्रोटेक्टेड एंड पद्मावत वाज रिलीज्ड इन एंटायर इंडिया. ओके, सिमिलरली रिसेंटली इन वन ऑफ द मैगजीन ऑफ मलयालम मैगजीन के ऊपर फ्रंट में एक जो ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग लेडी का फोटोग्राफ आया था और उसके ऊपर लोगों ने बोला था कि नहीं इसको रोक दिया जाए. ठीक है, तो सामने मैगजीन वाले ने बोला था दैट्स अवर फ्रीडम ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन एंड वी वुड लाइक टू यू कैन से कंटिन्यू विद इट. रिमेंबर भारत में जो फ्री प्रेस है ना, ऐसा कोई अलग से लॉ नहीं है. फ्री प्रेस डिराइव्स दिस फ्रीडम फ्रॉम दिस आर्टिकल नंबर 19. रिमेंबर दैट आर्टिकल नंबर 19 के द्वारा ही ये फ्रीडम डिराइव होता है. ओके, चलिए, ग्रेट. ओके, सो in this module, I think I'll be stopping it here because this is becoming a little longer. I will divide constitution second part in another session. तो आपको अगला एक session मिलेगा, which is still I'm talking about fundamental rights. Okay, I'll explain them in detail. So we have covered article number 14 and we have covered article number 19. Okay, so this is what article freedom related we have covered. We have also covered part 2 and part 1 in this video. Okay, and do not forget to subscribe our protalentdigital.com where we are going to give you very good PDF support for this kind of, again, say, study material. Okay, chaliye. So I thank you for watching this and I'm sure all of you must be sending this video to your friends, sharing on various social channels. Thank you very much. All the best. And if you have any query, please put that into comment section. Thank you very much.